In this video, we are going to see an introduction to PHP. So first, we'll see what is PHP. Expansion. What is PHP? Hypertext preprocessor. So how it works? First, we will see. This is a client side system, and this is a server. So a client requests through the HTML page. He'll enter the data, and he requests. His request will be sent to the server. There, the PHP process the request and then it render the data from the database. Okay, it is present in the server side database, and that will be the requested. As we have seen, the requested document will be processed by the PHP process from the database, and it will be again sent as a HTML file to the client side. So this is the logic. That is, from the customer side. From the client side, that when the client enters data or and he requests some data, so that data will be sent in the HTML file, in the HTML, to the web server. The web server will redirect that to the PHP processor, which in turn will extract the requested data of the user from the database and send again the data in the same HTML file. So it is a open source general purpose scripting language, and which is used for web development. It can be embedded inside a HTML as well as inside the PHP. You can embed a HTML. So it runs in different platforms. For example, it runs in a Sun microsystem. It runs in Mac. It runs in Linux, Windows, all the it works in all the platforms. So, and it is secure. The data sent through PHP is secure, and it can handle the handling of database through the PHP is easy, and you can understand very easily. And many databases can be used along with the PHP. Some of them are MySQL, PostgreSQL, Oracle, Sybase, and Microsoft SQL Server. It produces dynamic web pages. That's the main advantage of the PHP. And as we have seen, it is a server-side script because it extracts data from the database, which resides in the server, and then send the data. Whereas if you think JavaScript is a client-side scripting language. So whatever the user enter, that will be processed in the client side itself. And it will be sent to the web server. Whereas in PHP, once it is sent, after the HTML file is entered, the request is made, it will be processed in the server side. That is why it is called a server side script, server script. So let us go directly to PHP. PHP has a common syntax. It has to be, this anchor symbol has to be open, and then question mark followed by the keyword PHP. All are small. This is nothing but a print statement. So it's similar to a printf statement, cout statement in C++, in C and C++. So this displays the output. Then you have to close it with question mark and then the closing anchor bracket. So this is a very simple program, similar to your Hello World. Okay, when you see this, when you run this, you can see this output. Now, what are the requirements for a PHP? How you can execute a PHP? For that, you need a notepad. So you have to open a notepad and you can write a script. Or you can use Genie. There are so many open source editors. You can use them. So in this, I'm going to use completely notepad. Even you go for notepad plus. So that indentation and the highlighting of the keywords, all those things you can find. Then you need XAMPP or WAMP server, which is nothing but in PHP, this is mainly used for web development. So what we do is the same in which system you are installing the XAMPP server, that system itself is used both as a server as well as the local client. So that the developers can run their program and can see in their system itself, how it will look when from the client side. So you can use the same system as the client as well as the server. So it is mainly used for the developers. Then you need web browser to see your output. So these are all the main three necessity things for you to execute a PHP. So this already we have seen an open anchor symbol followed by question mark and PHP, then followed by the PHP code. Again, you have to close it. It's like similar to your curly flower braces in your C++ or C. After main, you will be opening a curly braces, and then after everything is over, again you close it with another curly braces. So this is similar to that. But here, the difference is, even if you have in a C or C++, do loop, while loop, that everywhere you use curly braces. But here, only starting of the PHP and closing of the PHP. Inside, when you have a loop, you are not supposed to use this. You can use just like your C++ curly braces. So we'll see when it comes, we'll see that. Now, each statement in PHP ends with semicolon. See, here's a small program, echo, welcome. We have started the PHP, echo, welcome, then semicolon. So all the statements must end with a, see here, it must end with a semicolon. Now, we'll come to the next one, PHP command statement. In any language, command statements are used for documentation. So that whenever the developer, after sometimes when he sees his coding, which he previously developed, he will have a clear idea if he has done the documentation. So what that program, what that function is doing, then in there we have, as a good developer, we have to do documentation. So we should say what the particular code or particular function is doing. So in order to do that, you can't write in a respective language syntax. So for that only, exclusively in each language, they have a command statement is given. So command statement, there are two types, one is single line command and multi-line command. So if you see that single line command, it starts with hash, this symbol, or double slash. So this is a single line. See, for example, this program. Here we have given double slash. This is a single line statement. So what is the meaning of a command statement? When you execute this program, whatever you have given in this, after this double slash, it will not get executed. So even if it is wrong, okay, even if something wrong you have written, so say for example some syntax, that will not get, you will not get any error message. So whatever you have to do is, you have to write your documentation. So for example, here you can write, this program is a welcome program. Like that you can write. See here, in this statement, I have not given the double slash here. Now this definitely will produce an error because this is not a PHP statement. It is a general statement. So when you execute this, this will lead to error. So in this statement, error will occur. So in order to avoid that, you have to give a hash or double slash before. And these are the single line statement. Single line statement, that statement will be over. You can write a single comment. Suppose I am tired of giving double slash in each line, then you can go for multi-line command. So it starts with slash start, then you can give many statements, all our documentations, and then you have to end it with start slash. This means whatever is given within will not get executed, you will not get any error. So it is used for documentation. Then PHP is very case sensitive. That is, means it will consider capital and small letter as different. So for example, I have a statement called, let me write it. Suppose I have a variable called. A variable can be declared in PHP with a dollar symbol. Okay, suppose I declare as some statement. Let us consider VAR. So this VAR and dollar, VAR. These two will be considered different. Even if the spelling is same, here we have small letter and here we have capital letter. So these two will be considered entirely different in a PHP. So you have to be careful in using the variable. We will see the echo on print statement. There are two. What we have seen in previous is echo statement. It is used for printing. Okay. Now we are going to see the print statement also. So what is the difference between echo and print? Echo can be used with or without parentheses. See, in this case, we have not used any parentheses. Like printf, you will after printf you will be giving a parenthesis. And then within that open, that is this quotes, within that only you will give the data, this message. Whereas here echo, there is no need for open and close parenthesis. Even if you give, it will not give error. Likewise, print statement, you can give print. Here also, there is no need for open and closed parenthesis. And it does not return any value. Whatever is given, it will just print. It can pass multiple strings separated by comma. See here, you can give like this. Suppose I want to print some data. Imagine, so I can give like this. So multiple parameters. So for example, as I said, here in PHP, all the variables starts with the dollar symbol. Suppose I have in dollar x, then dollar y. Already I have declared them to have consist of say dollar x equal to 5 and dollar y equal to 7. It is considered this statement. Here I can give, I can print these two variables in the same statement, like using comma. Whereas in print it is not possible. You have to, it will accept only single statement. So for example, if I give the same for print also, then it will give error. So what I have to do is I have to print separately. I have to write two separate statements for printing, for using the printing. So here it is faster than print. Echo is faster than print. Print, it delivers only one string. That's what I have just now said. Delivers only one string or variable to the output string. So you multiple arguments you cannot pass to the print. It cannot pass the multiple argument, and it returns an integer value 1, and it is slower than the echo. Now we are going to see execution of these programs.